Medic 25, please respond. 57-year-old male, unconscious, not breathing. 384 New Hempstead Road, New City.
We were making our way to the hospital, and you know, every couple of minutes, I'd ask him, are you all right? Are you okay? And I remember one last time asking, you all right? And he gave me this glassy-eyed look. I said, you okay? And then that's when everything took its spiral in another direction.
This would be a call paramedic Michael Ray would never forget. Ed Ilaraza, a man in his late 50s, had gone into cardiac arrest.
CPR had been started. We started to shock him.
Clear.
Shock him.
Clear. Shocking.
CPR continued and more medications, and shock him again.
At Good Samaritan Hospital in Suffern, New York, emergency room staff took over advanced life support. Cardiologist Carrie Hirsch was called in. He learned Ed had been in cardiac arrest for over 30 minutes.
When you go without more than 4 minutes of enough oxygen blood flow to the brain, then there can be brain damage.
Paramedic Ray decided to stay and help. His 15 years of experience told him it didn't look good.
Unless the supernatural occurs, this is not going to be a favorable, this is not going to be a favorable outcome.
Emergency room nurse Alicia Manaya had come to the same conclusion. When she told another nurse that Ed wasn't going to make it, Alicia was taken back by her response.
And she told me, you can't say that. And I'm like, why are you telling me that? It doesn't look good, I'm being honest.
The nurse told Alicia to go back into the room and tell them, don't stop working. She also told her to pray.
So the only thing I could do is just put my hope and faith in God. And I held his hand and I began to pray out loud in the middle of the cold.
I'm accustomed to, but
paramedic Ray was there when she started praying. So
from that point, I was like, if something's gonna happen that I've never seen before in my career, this is when it's gonna happen.
Meanwhile, Ed's family and friends had gathered in the waiting room and were praying. The updates from the ER all pointed to the inevitable, that Ed wouldn't make it. Ed's wife, Blanca, and their son, JP, were the first to arrive.
At one time, the doctor came out and said, you know, we've tried everything possible. I am so sorry. I just felt numbed. I couldn't believe this was taking place.
Then came the words everyone was waiting to hear.
Doctor screamed, he has a pulse, he has a pulse.
The whirlwind of emotion was hard on the family. Ed's son, JP, explained.
It was like in 1 second, you're imagining we gotta get ready for a funeral, and then the next second, the doctor comes out and she's like, he's a fighter, he's a fighter.
Ed's fight wasn't over. Immediately, he was taken to the cardiac unit where Dr. Hirsch and team worked to open his right artery, which was blocked. Time was running out.
An extraordinary number of times that Ed was defibrillated, both in the ambulance and when he arrived in the emergency room and when he, in fact, got into the catheterization laboratory. And that did not stop until we got the artery back open.
Blanca says she continued to trust God for the outcome.
I had that peace that the Lord was gonna perform this miracle.
In addition to the heart attack, Ed suffered a stroke. His brain had been deprived of oxygen for so long, doctors expected the damage to be extensive and most likely irreversible. The family could only wait and pray. Then 3 days later, Ed opened his eyes, his wife Blanca by his side.
I said, honey, do you recognize me?
And I was pretty surprised that she would ask me that because, of course, she was my wife.
Ed couldn't grasp what had happened over the past 3 days.
I must have asked my family about 100 times, what happened? Because even to me, it sounded unbelievable.
Until a camera crew from a local station came into his room and requested an interview.
One of their parishioners collapsed during
the word that was around town was that a miracle had happened at Good Sam Hospital, and that miracle was me.
I think
The whole thing is a miracle.
It was hailed as the Easter miracle, and for months, local news stations covered his recovery. But Ed still had a long way to go.
The heart attack was obviously an event, but the stroke was a bigger event.
First, Ed had to learn to walk again and do simple things like brush his teeth. He also realized he had to make some major lifestyle changes. He quit his two-pack-a-day cigarette habit and started eating right and exercising. He worked so hard that the staff at the rehab center took notice.
Therapists used to yell out at me, "What is it, you know, what is it with you? You want to do a marathon or something?" And, you know, I finally said to her, "Yes, you know, that's exactly what I want to do."
And that's exactly what he did. 6 months later, Ed ran his first half marathon, 13.1 miles. But he says he could never have done it on his own.
To finish a half a marathon, I knew that was the Lord. And I wanted to trumpet that. I wanted to herald that all over. Look, the Lord has healed me. He's not only healed me, he's made me better. He's really giving me a new life. I am now really reborn. A year later, I ran the New York City Marathon, which is 26.2 miles. And I'll tell you the truth, it's the 0.2 that gets you.
The change in his lifestyle was certainly is gratifying. The fact that he's running the marathon is amazing, but I would say more so is the cognitive function, which obviously no one could tell that Ed had been through any procedure like this or been through any event like this. I think that's more remarkable. There are a lot of people who have their heart muscle function return pretty much to normal, but not everybody makes a neurological recovery as well as he did.
Dr. Hirsch has a favorite word, and his favorite word is remarkable. And every time we sit together, I hear him say to me, "Wow, this is remarkable." I really believe he means miraculous.